Hi, AT from CNC at home. For Christmas, I got something a little interesting in my stocking. My daughter gave me this piece of basswood. I had asked her for something, a piece of wood or something, and she got that for me. And I was trying to figure out what to put on there, and I decided I was going to put a maze on there. Not quite sure why. I looked online and did some quick searching, found a maze that was round. I'll put that up here. No, over here. I'll put that over here for what that looks like. I took that image into Photoshop and I did some manipulation on it. I inversed it because the software that I use will cut where the black is, not where the white is, so I wanted to do an inverse on that. And I also needed to make it larger. The dark area. So I drew a circle around the whole thing, tried to get it centered up, and that gave me some area to cut around the whole maze. So I did that in Photoshop, and I exported that into some software called F-Engrave. And there I set up all my parameters to do the cutting. I'll show that here in just a minute. Exported that code into my sending application and did some cutting on it. Anyway, I want to show you that process. I'm not going to go into great detail, for instance, on how the Photoshop stuff works. It's an image, so we'll just take that on face value. I will step through how I used F-Engrave. It's a free software. I'll put the link to their site down in the description. And show you or step through the how I get that set up, the parameters and that sort of thing. So we'll do that, and then we will take the wood, get it set up in the CNC router. It's been a while since we've used that, and we'll cut this maze out of the chunk of wood. Let's go take a look at that. Remember to give this video a thumbs up. Here's the F-Engrave program. The first thing I'm going to do is open my file, and we can take a look at that. Now that the image is loaded, we can go over and set some of our parameters. The height of this image I want to increase. I'm going to do this at 175 millimeters. So we'll make that adjustment, and I want my feed rate to be 400 millimeters, and my safe distance I use 2 millimeters. It's kind of close, but this is a very flat piece of material, so I'm not too worried about it. In settings, I'm going to go to the V-carve settings, and here I want to use a straight cutting type. That's just an end mill. And it's a 3.175 millimeter, it's a 1/8 inch. My cutting depth, I want to be 4 millimeters down. And we'll do sub-step 1. Some of the stuff we don't have to do anything with or change. I do want to do multiple passes, so I'm going to set this, and I want the last pass to be kind of a finer one, so I'm just going to take off a 0.5 millimeter of material. And my max depth per pass, I'm going to set to 2, so I'll do 2 millimeters at a time, except that last one really will be 1.5. So let's change this to 0.25. It'll be just a little bit of material. And then we'll talk about the cleanup here in a second. So let's go ahead and click the calculate. This will take a little while, so I will fast forward through this. Here the black represents the cutting path that's going to take place. As we can see, there are some spots such as the center of this, and then there's these little spots in the corners where cutting the edge doesn't hit these spots. That's where the cleanup comes into place. We're going to use the same size tool, and my overlap is going to be 40%. And that's overlapping from one tool pass to the next. That really is only going to affect the center
where I'm taking out a big chunk of material. Let's go ahead and calculate the cleanup. This will come in a different color. Here we can see our cleanup in red, and it takes care of all those little extra pieces that didn't get cut out during the main part. Now that we have our G code ready to go, I'll need to save that. The cleanup code I save from here, so I'll go ahead and click that. Now that that's saved, we'll close out our settings. So double check this, we're still good here. And under File, we can save our G code, and this will be for the main part of the cutting. That's all we end up doing in F-Engrave. Let's take this into our sending software and take a look at it. I'm using a program called Universal G-Code Sender. This seems to work pretty well for my needs. Normally, the first thing you would do is attach to the appropriate COM port. I'm using a different computer right now, so the CNC router isn't actually connected to this computer, so I'm going to skip that step, which would also involve coming over and clicking the $H, which is the home command, and other things to get the router set up. What I am going to do is click on Browse and go ahead and open the G-code that we just created, and then we'll be able to visualize that. Here's our G-code, and I'll go ahead and click on the Visualize. This shows us what it's kind of going to do. The yellow bar represents our cutting tool, and then we can alter our perspective or point of view. One thing that this software does not do is it does not run a simulation of the cut, so I can't go through and kind of watch how it's going to do stuff. I can see what it's going to do. This kind of teal colored path from the center out is just a movement, and then the green is a plunge down, and then the white paths are then the cutting paths themselves. While you're doing a real cut, this yellow bar does move and does simulate the cutting, and it erases stuff as it goes through. So you do kind of get a simulation at that point, but it's while you're actually doing the cutting. Anyway, that's all there is to it. The other thing we could take a look at is our cleanup. So we'll just look at our cleanup code and visualize on that. As you can see, it's quite a bit different. Again, starting in the center, it's going to hog out this middle area, and then it'll just kind of make its way around and get rid of these little pieces here and there that needed to be chopped down. That's the software side of things. Why don't we go ahead and take a look at the router. We'll get the piece of wood centered up, do some measuring to make sure that it fits properly, that the clamps aren't in the way, and then we'll start the cutting. I spent a fair amount of time trying to get the piece of wood really centered on the working area. The size of our cut is going to be 175 millimeters, and this router is 300 by 180 maximum. So we're flirting with limits here. And so I got it centered up, and I did a dry run where the tool, I had it not spin, and I brought it down close to the surface so I could make sure we weren't going to hit the clamps and that we weren't hitting any limits. Once I had done that, I went ahead and started running the code, and here's what happened. While I was monitoring this cut, I did bring the vacuum in every once in a while and clean some of the wood shavings away. The main cutting is done and now the cleanup coat is running. It hogged out that center and is getting rid of the little pieces that were left over as it was cutting the perimeter of the maze. This cut is also doing three passes. Each one is 2 millimeters, where the last one is just shy of 2 millimeters and doing that final 0.25 millimeter cleanup cut. It wasn't until after I had done all of this cutting that I realized I wanted to have a BB down in the maze. I was thinking maybe something on top, but a BB fits nice in this section, but around the perimeter, it doesn't. It flows nicely here, but when we go out to the outer ring, there's not enough room. So what I need to do is recut to that outer circle. And to do that, I didn't want to rebuild the whole code, so I just programmed in a G2 command, which is a clockwise arc. So the G2 command takes an X, Y, I, and J parameter. The X and Y are the ending points, your current location is your starting point, and the I and J parameters are the distance from your starting point to the center of the arc. Once you code those things in, then you let it loose, and away it goes. It took a bit of doing to get this board back into the router and centered up how it had been, and after a bunch of time, I got it pretty darn close. This new arc is going to be 1 millimeter bigger in diameter than the old one. So the radius is 88 millimeters. My tool is 3.175 millimeters in diameter. So from the center of the cut to the edge of the tool is 1.5875 millimeters. This makes the center of my cutting path 86.4125 millimeters. So I start at X of minus 86.4125 and Y of 0. Then here's the code that I run. The first code is to set absolute coordinates, that's to G90. These next few lines are to ramp the motor up to 100%. The power supply isn't strong enough to go from just nothing to full power, so I go 40%, 60, 80, and then finally 100% or full speed. I have my controller set so that 1000, S1000 is full power. Then I move to my starting coordinates, plunge the router down into the material, and then run my G2 arc command. Once it's done, pull the router bit out and stop the motor. If you know just a little bit of G coding, you can write similar kinds of codes and run it directly then on your router. Now that the cut is complete, we'll get the vacuum out and do a little bit of cleanup and see how well that fits. Now with the cleanup done, we'll put the little BB in there and we see that it rolls freely around the outer circle. That means we made it big enough.
Well, that turned out pretty well. Here's the finished product. One thing that we did have to do is we had to increase the size of this channel around the outside edge. As we saw in the video, I hadn't really thought about using a little BB in there when I was doing the design work, so I didn't have the space for it. It looked like it might work, but when we put a BB in there, it would get stuck. So I just had to increase the size of that. Anyway, great project. It was fun. I hope you enjoyed the video. Remember to give it a thumbs up. And if you like our content, think about subscribing. That really helps the channel. And enjoy doing your CNC at home projects.
Initially with this project, I thought I was going to paint the maze. And to do that, I wanted to make sure that I would be able to clean off any paint that was on the surface. So I took a piece of scrap wood and I prepared it with a clear lacquer like I did with my piece of basswood. I brought it into the router and just cut a groove that was 4 millimeters deep and 10 millimeters long. Once this is cleaned up, I took it out to the garage, sprayed it with some black spray paint to get down in there, and then wiped off the surface and used a little bit of lacquer thinner to get the paint off. We'll take a look here and see how that turned out. Not too bad, actually. Turned out pretty well. You can see a little bit of paint on the sides of the board, but not on top where I cleaned it. Because of how small the walls are on the maze, I decided not to paint it this dark black. But the experiment proved successful, and I may use that in a future project.